everyone, and welcome to Live at 4 on this sunny Tuesday.
Yeah, a nice day outside. 1 week to go until Election Day. It's a busy day today.
It is a busy news day. Let's start with this. Governor Tony Evers is asking people to stay home and only go out for essential things as the state tries to get a major COVID outbreak under control.
A week after the game of his life, Badger quarterback Graham Mertz has tested positive for COVID-19, and he's not the only one on the team with it.
Mertz is one of 69,000 new cases around the country. How doctors across the country are fighting the virus as nationwide hospitalizations jump nearly 40%.
The new data from Wisconsin health officials shows two alarming statistics. The first, 57 more people have lost their lives from COVID-19 in Wisconsin. The other, Wisconsin could break a record this evening for the number of new COVID-19 cases reported in a day. State health officials reported more than 4,700 new cases this afternoon, outside of a period when officials were releasing a backlog of new cases. News 3 Now's COVID tracker record is now at more than 4,800 new cases in a day. You may have seen a higher number released today by the Wisconsin Department of Health Services. However, we reported many of those cases last night as counties continue to update their data. Wisconsin is in a COVID crisis.
That's how DHS Secretary Designee Andrea Palm is describing the surge in cases. Brady Mallory joins us now with the latest numbers and a plea from the governor to slow the spread. Brady.
Right, both Governor Evers and Palm say it's up to all of us to keep people from getting sick and to keep the hospital workers from becoming overwhelmed with even more patients. There are 5,262 more confirmed cases of COVID-19 today. That puts Wisconsin's overall total since the pandemic began to 206,311. And you already touched on the number of people who have died. Well, there's another grim number to report. Palm says the 7-day average of new cases is 3,975. Up from a 700 case average 2 months ago. That's more than a 400% increase. Now, the governor didn't mandate a stay-at-home order, but he's asking everyone to only go out for the essentials and avoid even the small gatherings with people who you don't live with.
And we can prevent the deaths of people in Wisconsin by staying home. If that's considered a self-imposed lockdown, whatever it is, it's important.
Evers also says to remember the basics, like washing your hands and wearing your masks. Palm says right now contact tracers are overwhelmed and hospital workers are busier than ever.
All right, Brady, thank you. Those high numbers are making more and more people want to get tested.
And that's leading to yet more long lines waiting to get tested at the Alliant Energy Center. News 3 Now's Madeline O'Neill joins us with more. Maddie?
Well, coming into the Alliant Energy Center testing site here, signs say it will be a 3+ hour wait to get tested for COVID-19. If you've been watching us in recent weeks, you know this isn't new. This is the fourth Tuesday in a row there have been substantial wait times, and that's since Public Health Madison Dane County took over testing here from the National Guard. Now, Public Health said they're too busy for an interview today, but did direct me to a Facebook post they had yesterday saying that you should avoid Tuesdays if at all possible, reminding people who should and shouldn't be getting tested. They recommend those who have symptoms, who have been around those who do have COVID-19 or work with populations at risk should get tested. Otherwise, you shouldn't get tested for peace of mind. Now, usually testing goes until 8 o'clock tonight. Public Health says they might close early because of those long lines.
All right, Madeline O'Neill reporting, thank you. The U.S. is now averaging more than 69,000 new COVID-19 cases a day. Nationwide, that is a new all-time high. COVID-19 hospitalizations nationwide have also jumped nearly 40% in the last month. Michael George has the latest from New York, where state officials announced new measures to slow the spread.
Milwaukee's mayor stood in front of 600 empty chairs Tuesday to remember those lost to COVID-19.
It's a stark reminder, a lonely reminder, a sad reminder of what we're living through right now.
As cases surge in the city, officials are putting new restrictions on gatherings at bars and restaurants. Wisconsin is one of the states with the highest number of new daily cases.
It's never been worse for us here in Wisconsin, and every day it's not getting better. It's getting a little bit worse.
In Illinois, the 7-day average for new cases topped 4,500 for the first time since the pandemic began, sparking new restrictions in more than half the state.
We have got to reverse the trend and slow the spread of this virus.
In Utah, experts warn that doctors may have to soon ration health care.
There's really no end in sight for us. Our hospitalizations are continuing to rise, so there's no rounding the curve for us here in Utah.
Here in New York, state officials are taking steps to prevent college students from spreading the virus into their home communities during the Thanksgiving break.
The state's public university system is requiring all students to test negative before they can leave for the holiday. A new Harvard study finds the risk of catching the virus on a plane could be lower than at a grocery store, as long as mask wearing and other safety protocols are followed. Michael George, CBS News, New York.
And New York City's mayor called on the federal government today to create a mandate that anyone traveling by plane must have a proof of a negative test in the 72 hours before the flight. Let's check in on the weather now. Pretty day. Boy, that's a nice shot. Lake Wingrim. Weather words, not as chilly. More good news. Dana's in the backyard in the sunshine.
Right now, we're sunny. It's still a little chilly for this evening, but as we look ahead to Wednesday, that's when things will finally get a little nicer outside as far as our temperatures are concerned. We're at about 40 in Madison. Finally, it's been a few days since we've hit 40 degrees with partly sunny skies. Our breeze now shifting and becoming more of a west-southwest flow. So that warmer air will help our temperatures climb a little more for Wednesday. 40 in Madison, 40 in Monroe, but we're still in the upper 30s towards the Dells and for much of Sauk County. This is very close to where we were at to this time yesterday for much of the area. Just a few degrees warmer, but not a big jump. We did start the day off in the 20s in Dane County, but look a little further north, Black River Falls, starting the day at just 12 degrees. A very chilly start to the day, and we aren't expecting overnight lows to drop quite as much for tonight or for the rest of the week. But we will take a closer look at your full 10-day coming up in just a few minutes.
All right, Dana, thank you. President Trump is holding a rally outside of La Crosse this afternoon. He's at the La Crosse Speedway in West Salem. It's one of several trips the campaign has planned in Wisconsin this week. Vice President Mike Pence will be in Mosinee tomorrow, and Second Lady Karen Pence will also be in Wisconsin tomorrow. She'll hold an event in Waterloo. Election Day, as we mentioned, is 1 week from today. President Trump is stumping across the Midwest. In addition to La Crosse, the president is also holding rallies in Michigan and Nebraska, while former Vice President Joe Biden campaigns in Georgia.
You know, they give you the fake polls. I think we're up a lot more. We're going to have a great red wave, people that want to go out and vote.
With our voices and our votes, we must free ourselves from the forces of darkness, from the forces of division, and the forces of yesterday. From the forces that pull us apart, hold us down, and hold us back.
Former President Barack Obama campaigned for the Democratic ticket in Orlando, Florida. Vice President Mike Pence crisscrossed the Carolinas for multiple rallies after saying he once again tested negative for COVID-19. Due to a recent outbreak among the vice president's close staffers, new procedures have been put in place to limit his contact with others.
Clerks want you to get your ballots in as soon as possible following the Supreme Court's definitive answer last night. Absentee ballots received after 8 p.m. on November 3rd won't be counted in Wisconsin. Amy Reed shows us what one group behind the original lawsuit wants voters with disabilities to know now.
Months after filing and a week before the election, these voters got their answer, but it wasn't the one they were looking for. Disability Rights Wisconsin sued after the April election. They heard from voters who lost out on their right to vote. They wanted changes for this election, including an extension on when ballots could get in. With the court's decision yesterday, they want those with disabilities to know their rights and know they are there to help.
If you're a voter with a disability and you're struggling, give us a call at the Disability Rights Wisconsin voter helpline. We're open every day, so you can give us a call at 844-DIS-VOTE, and we will work with you to see what the options are.
The Elections Commission warns, no matter your circumstance, make your plans now.
Well, could COVID-19 stop the Badger season in its tracks just as it gets started?
After a historic debut, quarterback Graham Mertz has tested positive a second time. Eric Franke is here now with more details. Eric.
Susan and Mark, it appears 2020 has struck again. Graham Mertz tested positive for COVID after that debut against Illinois. The second confirmation test also came back positive. So he's out for 21 days per Big Ten rules. Mertz shredding Illinois on Friday in his first start. 5 touchdown passes. Last year's starter, Jack Cohn, still out after foot surgery just 3 weeks ago. Chase Wolf is next in line, but he reportedly had a positive COVID test, and we are still waiting for the results of a second confirmation test on Wolf. So number 15, Danny Vandenboom would be next in line. These three games are Saturday at Nebraska, back home to face Purdue, then what figures to be a very difficult road test at Michigan November 14th. Now, if it is Vandenboom, many remember his dad Matt was an All-American for the Badgers back in the early 80s. Danny's one career pass came 2 years ago. It was a 3-yard touchdown pass against New Mexico. But again, we are still waiting on the status of Chase Wolf. Per Big Ten rules, based on a roster of 113 Badger players, if 6 of them test positive, that game will have to be canceled. Mark and Susan?
2020. Thanks, Eric.
You bet.
It is clear that what Wisconsin has been doing to stop the spread is not working. Last week, Dr. Deborah Birx, a member of the White House Coronavirus Task Force, said where the state is doing something right is on UW campuses. They're testing students weekly, a way to find asymptomatic cases, and quarantining them. That's people who have the virus but don't even know it. Dr. Birx suggested communities follow the UW system's lead and proactively test 18 to 30-year-olds. But is that possible? Logistically, no. But we can still learn from UW's success.
But the testing was not what prevented the infections. That's not what stopped the outbreak. What stopped the outbreak was when they found cases, they were isolated. They had a separate dormitory where if someone tested positive, they moved out of their room, their dorm, out of the environment where they shared space with other people, into an environment where they were isolated.
Dr. Birx also suggested this testing expand to other colleges, such as technical colleges. On News 3 Now at 6, Amanda Quintana will show us how that plan would also be difficult to pull off.
A deadly police shooting led to anger and violence overnight in Philadelphia. The unrest was sparked when police killed a man who walked toward two officers carrying a large knife. Cell phone video shows police telling 27-year-old Walter Wallace to drop the weapon, but he continues walking toward the officers. Wallace's mother is then seen grabbing her son in an effort to intervene, but he breaks away, heading in the direction of police, who then open fire. Wallace was hit in the shoulder and chest.
Upon being struck, the male immediately dropped the knife and was scooped up by one of the discharging officers, who took him into his police car, drove him over to Presbyterian Hospital, where unfortunately he succumbed to his injuries.
They need to stop pulling their guns first and pull their tasers first. It would be less killing.
In the aftermath of the shooting, protesters demanded answers from the police. In a statement, Philadelphia Mayor Jim Kenney said he watched the video of the incident and it raised difficult questions that need answering.
Some Pecatonica students were told to go home this morning after school officials were notified of a group of COVID-19 cases. 6th through 12th graders at the Pecatonica middle and high schools found out at 8:30 this morning while they were at school. They'll be going to virtual classes until Monday, November 9th. Still to come at 4, are you tired of the soaring cable and satellite TV bills? Many are cutting the cord.
Consumer Report shows us how to get most of the channels that you want for under $25. We'll have that story when Live at 4 continues.
You're watching News 3 Now, Live at 4.
Things can change in a heartbeat. I know. My wife and 3 children were Christmas shopping. Tractor trailer killed my wife and killed my daughter. I was probably the only senator to ever sworn in a hospital because I didn't want to leave my sons.
For Joe Biden, health care access is personal. And in coronavirus's wake, we need Joe's plan. Double the number of testing sites, free vaccines, save and extend Obamacare. A real plan and the resilience to lead the way. FFPAC is responsible for the content of this ad.
The Social Security Administration just released a report saying that if a plan like the one Trump is proposing goes into effect, the Social Security Trust Fund would be, and I quote, permanently depleted by the middle of calendar year 2023. Put it plainly, Trump's plan would wipe out Social Security. If I'm your president, we're going to protect Social Security and Medicare.
You have my word. I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
I can't believe it.
What? That our new house is haunted by Casper the Friendly Ghost?
Hey, Jill. Hey, Kurt. Movies? Oh. I'll get snacks.
No, I can't believe how easy it was to save hundreds of dollars on our car insurance with Geico.
I got snacks. Ooh, I got popcorn. I got caramel corn. I got kettle corn. Right.
Am I too loud?
Believe it. Geico could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
So step one, U.S. Cellular pays you back for your unused data at the end of the month.
Okay. And step two?
There is no step two.
So you just pay me back for unused data?
Yes.
Okay. Run me through that one more time.
Which part?
Just the whole thing part.
Got it. So step one.
If you've forgotten what a fair deal sounds like, let us remind you. Switch to U.S. Cellular, the network ranked number one in network quality by J.D. Power. U.S. Cellular. Upgrade to fair.
We all know that on its own, his work does not capture the full measure of Joe Biden. Folks don't just feel like they know Joe, the politician. They feel like they know the person. When Joe sticks up for the little guy, we hear the young boy who used to stand in front of the mirror, determined to vanquish a debilitating stutter. When Joe talks to auto workers whose livelihoods he helped save, we hear the son of a man who once lost his job. When Joe talks about hope and opportunity for our children, we hear the father who rode the rails home every night so he could be there to tuck his kids into bed. When Joe talks to Gold Star families who've lost a hero, we hear another father of an American veteran, somebody whose faith has been tested and who knows who to lean on to find the light, a resilient and loyal and humble servant. And through his life, he has never once forgotten the values and the moral fiber that made him who he is. The best part is he's nowhere close to finish.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
Welcome back, everyone. Hertz is trying to help you get to the polls this election season.
The rental car company says on November 2nd or 3rd, it'll give away one free day when customers reserve a car for 2 days. Hertz says this will make it easier for people to perform their civic duty. The promotion is available at Hertz neighborhood locations across the country. Other transportation companies are also running deals on election day. Both Uber and Lyft are offering discounted rides to the polls. It is Travel Tuesday.
If you plan to take a road trip for the upcoming winter holidays, AAA offers a couple of resources to help you plan your trip. A COVID-19 travel restriction map shows which areas around the country are experiencing spikes and where there are travel restrictions. TripTick allows you to chart your route, even picking some rest areas and where to eat, so you have more time to concentrate on the scenery.
That's because road trips provide a lot of flexibility, and especially this time around, comfort. You're in your own vehicle, you're among your family, you're among your friends.
Doctors recommend taking Clorox spray and 70% alcohol wipes to wipe down surfaces, including handles at gas stations. For many Americans, the holiday shopping season is well underway.
A recent survey from Affirm found nearly half started buying gifts online in September. But the shift to the web and the pandemic are having a big impact on local retailers. Experts say foot traffic in retail stores is down, and consumers are cutting spending too. About 52% expect their total holiday spending to be less than last year. And according to a recent survey, nearly half of respondents plan to do their holiday shopping online.
Just to be a little bit safer, July was kind of more of a lesson learned to actually take a little bit more time shopping for things instead of waiting for last minute.
With unemployment and stimulus uncertainty, many may not spend as much, or they may spend more since they aren't traveling and may be looking for some retail therapy. Yes, I agree. It was a mixed day on Wall Street following some bad earnings reports, but tech stocks soared. The Dow Industrials lost 222 points, closing at 27,463. The tech-heavy NASDAQ was up 72, but the S&P 500 was off 10. Well, how does spending just $25 a month on TV sound to you? Can you still get the channels and shows you love?
Well, with so many cord-cutting options out there, Consumer Reports set out to see what you could actually get for $25. Leah Lynchai reports.
Daphne Pena and her husband decided to get rid of cable a few years ago after paying too much each month.
We were streaming more
and it didn't make any sense to pay for something that we weren't using.
But Consumer Reports tech editor Jim Wilcox says some people are spending as much money on various streaming services as they were on cable.
I wanted to see if it was possible to get a good assortment of content and broadcast channels for just $25 a month.
Since every family has different interests and favorite shows, Jim put together an economical package that could appeal to a wide range of people. It includes CBS All Access, a Disney Plus bundle, and Peacock, NBC Universal's new offering.
For sports fans, CBS All Access has NFL games through 2022, plus Super Bowl 55. And you get NCAA basketball and PGA golf.
Plus CBS programs and content from BET, Comedy Central, MTV, and more, with limited commercials at $6 a month. The Disney Plus bundle includes Hulu and ESPN Plus for $13 a month.
For families with kids, Disney Plus has the Star Wars franchise, plus movies from Marvel and Pixar.
Hulu offers content from popular broadcast and cable channels like Fox and ABC, plus classic TV shows, Hulu originals, and movies. And ESPN Plus adds even more sports to the mix.
The last piece of the streaming puzzle is the $5 a month ad-supported tier of Peacock.
With it, you get next-day access to NBC's current shows and content from Bravo, Sci-Fi, Telemundo, and USA Network. Altogether, that's about $24 a month. On top of streaming, many people, like Daphne, want free live broadcast channels.
We also have an antenna because we like to watch local news.
For News 3 Now, this is Leah Lynchide. Yes,
now, some streaming companies offer promotional pricing or even free access with other services like music subscriptions.
And most also offer free trials so you can make sure it's the right fit for your family before signing up.
$24 a month.
Not bad.
Impressive.
All right, still to come at four, a number of states are make or break for both presidential candidates.
We'll look at the role that each state will have on Election Day coming up after Dana's warmer forecast.
Hey, Madison voters, don't let the pandemic suppress your vote. Create your safe voting plan now. You have options. Visit cityofmadison.com/clerk to create your safe voting plan today. Brought to you by the Madison City Clerk's Office.
And how you can protest.
Let's turn off the noise and look at the facts about Joe Biden and Kamala Harris's government-run health care plan. Their plan could lead to hospitals being closed, put Medicare coverage at risk, and give benefits to illegal immigrants. Their plan is just too dangerous for seniors like us. No amount of noise will change that. Learn more at seniorsbeware.com.
I'm Donald Trump, and I approve this message.
The Medicare enrollment deadline is only weeks away, and there's so many unanswered questions. Like, do you know if your plan is still the right fit? Having the wrong Medicare plan can cost you thousands. And that's why I love Health Markets, your insurance marketplace. What if you didn't have to shop for health insurance again? Health Markets FitScore Forever Promise is the answer. It continuously scans the market to compare your plan against any new options year after year, while helping answer all your Medicare questions, like does your plan have no copays, no deductibles, or $0 premiums? Health Markets has the answer. Does your plan offer dental and vision coverage? How about hearing aids, glasses, wellness visits, and even telemedicine at no additional cost? Health Markets has the answers. Find the answer from the number one ranked health insurance agency in America.
Your insurance marketplace, Health Markets.
Call 800-964-0790. That's 800-964-0790. Call now.
Here at Harker Heating and Cooling of Madison, we are proudly celebrating over 70 years of excellence. A lot can change in 70 years, but some things never do, like our commitment to providing our customers with 100% satisfaction every single day. When you make that call to Harker, you can be rest assured that a team of qualified, trustworthy, skilled individuals are ready to address your home service concerns. Harker Heating and Cooling, your hometown heroes for over 70 years.
Harker Heating and Cooling.
If you elect me, your taxes are going to be raised, not cut.
What does that mean for you? Household incomes down $6,500 a year. Higher gas prices at the pump and utility bills at home.
And here's how it works. I'm going to raise taxes.
Small businesses pay more. 5 million jobs lost.
You're going to get a tax raise.
An economy in ruins. That's what Joe Biden's tax increase means for you.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
Hey, Madison voters, don't let the pandemic suppress your vote. Create your safe voting plan now. You have options. Visit cityofmadison.com/clerk to create your safe voting plan today. Brought to you by the Madison City Clerk's Office.
Take a look at this. Wow, let's take another look. This pilot buzzes right over the top of a newlywed couple standing in a cotton field in Brazil, basically baptizing the bride and groom. The unique idea is the brainchild of a professional photographer. The group did a number of dry runs before the photographer was in radio contact with the pilot before they did the real thing.
Oh, so this was intentional.
Yes, they wanted a dramatic wedding picture.
I thought it was an accident. Got it. Dramatic either way.
Very dramatic. I like the rainbow that pops up behind him in the background, too. That turned out really cool.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's a wedding picture that you're going to remember.
I like it.
Boy, it feels nice out there today, Dana. Yeah. Nice to see the sun.
Nice to see the sun, and as long as you just wear a jacket, it's a little chilly, but really pleasant for the end of October. Again, as long as you just have the jacket on. There's the sunshine coming through. The rest of our forecast does include a lot of the sun. If you're not sick of it yet, it's going to be hanging around. We'll take a closer look at your 10-day right after the break.
We aren't radical, so why would we want one representing us in Madison? Chris Marion is an extreme partisan liberal who's just fine with calling political opponents Nazis, dictators, and enemies. And Chris Marion wants to take more of your paycheck, too. Marion supports eliminating levy limits, causing property taxes to skyrocket, crushing families as they try to recover. And Marion backs the radical Green New Deal that will cost trillions, destroy jobs, and increase taxes. Chris Marion, just too radical.
If you elect me, your taxes are going to be raised, not cut.
What does that mean for you? Household incomes down $6,500 a year. Higher gas prices at the pump and utility bills at home.
And here's how it works. I'm going to raise taxes.
Small businesses pay more. 5 million jobs lost.
You're going to get a tax raise.
An economy in ruins. That's what Joe Biden's tax increase means for you.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
You were always the responsible one. So much like me. Always taking care of everyone else. But this wasn't your responsibility. I already took care of the arrangements. The Ryans made it so easy. I didn't want you to worry about a thing. It's my last gift to you, my lovely daughter.
People were afraid I was contagious. I felt gross.
It was kind of a shock after I started Cosentyx.
4 years clear.
Real people with psoriasis look and feel better with Cosentyx. Don't use if you're allergic to Cosentyx. Before starting, get checked for tuberculosis. An increased risk of infections and lowered ability to fight them may occur. Tell your doctor about an infection or symptoms. If your inflammatory bowel disease symptoms develop or worsen, or if you've had a vaccine or plan to, serious allergic reactions may occur. Learn more at Cosentyx.com.
If I have the honor of being president, I promise you I will lead. My plan lowers healthcare costs, gets us to universal coverage quickly when Americans desperately need it. By making it less expensive for Americans to choose plans with lower deductibles and out-of-pocket expenses. By lowering prescription drug prices. By ending the practice of so-called surprise billings. When I'm president, I will take care of your healthcare coverage and your family the same way I would my own.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
Let us help you create your family's recipe for health. SSM Health and News 3 Now are making it easy by putting all the ingredients right at your fingertips. With topics like healthy habits, nutrition, and mental well-being, there's something for everyone. Visit Channel 3000's Time for Kids page for advice from SSM Health experts.
And catch fresh and informative reports on News 3 Now.
Take time for kids with SSM Health and News 3 Now.
News 3 Now First Warn Weather is brought to you by Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor.
Discover a shopping and design experience as comfortable as the furniture. Lazy Boy Home Furnishings and Decor. Schedule your free design consultation today.
Sunny and chilly and very fall-like outside, not just for today, but for much of the 10-day forecast. We don't have any rain in sight at all the entire 10-day. We've taken out any slight opportunities for some light showers. We may see a few more clouds increasing, but staying dry. Sunglasses should be on hand as we're going to see several days with mostly sunny skies and the temperature trend still below average. We'll stay chilly as we look ahead through the week. By next week, we'll be closer to average, but at least for this week, things are going to stay a little cool outside. The sun nice and bright, barely a cloud in the sky right now. Should be a very nice evening as long as you have a jacket on, as it is still just a little chilly. Doppler track is quiet. If you look well to the north, we do have some light flurries north of the Twin Cities, but nothing that's going to be impacting our area. Again, we really don't have any moisture building in for the next several days. Very dry trend ahead. So things will feel dry outside. The air is a little dry. Our dew points are low, but it comes along with the sunshine, and this is a pretty average pattern for the end of October. Overnight, skies will be mostly clear. It is going to be cold to start off Wednesday. Temperatures are dropping to about 30 degrees for our overnight lows. So not quite as cold as we were this morning. We started the day off in the mid-20s, and again, areas north of the Dells saw overnight lows in the teens. We'll hold off on that for a few more nights. For Wednesday afternoon, we have sunshine with highs near 50 degrees, so about a 10-degree jump from today. A little more cloud coverage building in on Thursday. We will have variably cloudy skies, but we've taken out any small chances for some light drizzle. It just doesn't look likely for us on Thursday. It's too dry outside. Temperatures will be a bit cooler in the afternoon, but then we are starting to see a little more of a warming trend. Looking 6 to 10 days out, becoming more likely that our temperatures will trend above average for much of the plains in the Midwest, and that trend continues in our 8 to 14 day outlook, which starts to push us towards the middle of November. So temperatures as we look ahead into next week, the end of next week and the following week, quite likely that our temperatures will be trending above average. Still very likely though that we will be seeing that drier trend sticking around. High tomorrow of about 50 degrees, mostly sunny skies, and certainly not as chilly as today with our afternoon highs and with our overnight lows. We're mostly sunny for Wednesday, variably cloudy on Thursday, and a bit cooler outside for Thursday and Friday, but we're back up in the 50s by Halloween on Saturday. Saturday will be dry, partly sunny skies, a little breezy outside, and once the sun does set, those temperatures will drop in the 40s. So you'll want to make sure you keep the jacket on hand for the weekend. Also, for Election Day Tuesday, we'll see mostly sunny skies, temperatures trending back to the mid-50s for the middle of next week, which pushes us above average for the first week of November.
Well, that's just about perfect for Election Day, though.
Exactly. Weather is not going to be a part of the news that day, so that's good. We need it to be quiet.
Thank you, Dana. Mm-hmm. Well, California is seeing another day of severe fire danger.
More strong winds are whipping up fast-moving wildfires south of Los Angeles. They've already forced more than 90,000 people to leave their homes. Two wind-driven wildfires continue to threaten thousands of homes in Orange County. Firefighters kept a close watch on shifting embers throughout the night, hoping to protect nearby neighborhoods. The Silverado Fire, which started yesterday morning, is shutting down freeways and forcing evacuations. The race for the White House is being fought in a handful of battleground states, including Wisconsin.
Natalie Brand spoke with voters in the battleground state of Pennsylvania and looks at the other states that could make or break for the presidential candidates on Election Day.
In the battleground state of Pennsylvania, the signs are everywhere, from roadside tributes to street corner competition to the line at this ballot drop box in York County.
Who did you vote for mine?
He doesn't even know who I voted for.
We haven't told each other because we're pretty much split.
But one thing they can agree on.
It's going to be tight.
It's not just simply who flips a county here and there. It's about margins.
CBS News Director of Elections and Surveys Anthony Salvanto says the strength of the candidates' performance will matter in the key counties of the key states.
There's a couple of big themes running through the electoral map this year, and one of them is the Sun Belt and the Rust Belt.
That includes states President Trump won in 2016 that are now back in play: Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Ohio. And Sun Belt states the president is also trying to defend: Florida, North Carolina, Georgia, Arizona, even Texas.
Voters in those states have told us that they were unhappy with how the Trump administration handled the COVID outbreak.
While the pandemic is an election year challenge unlike any other, one trend that's carried over from 2016, the rural-urban divide. Southwestern Pennsylvania's coal country voted overwhelmingly for the president 4 years ago.
When he came in, things got better.
Republican Bruce Cochran, a small business owner, believes Mr. Trump still has the edge.
I think people feel that they're better off now than they were 4 years ago.
200 miles east, back in York County, Mary Tribu has a different view.
I'm afraid if he gets four more years, this country will be totally destroyed.
High early turnout shows voters are eager to have a say.
Thank you.
You know, everybody's got their voice right now, and we'll see what the people decide.
And once the battle for their state is over, voters on both sides say they'd like to see the country come together. Natalie Brand, CBS News, Pennsylvania.
More than 60 million Americans have already cast their ballots.
Some swing states have already set records for early voting. There's more to come at 4 later on. We're talking about adolescent mental health during the pandemic.
And then coming up tonight at 5, lots of organizations are helping people get to the polls next week. We'll run through some of the options coming up tonight at 5.
We are the thrivers. Women with metastatic breast cancer, standing in the struggle, hustling through the hurt, asking for science, not sorries. Our time for more time has come. Living longer is possible and proven in women taking Kisqali plus fulvestrant or a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor. Kisqali is the only treatment in its class with proven overall survival results in 2 clinical trials, helping women live longer with HR-positive, HER2-negative metastatic breast cancer. Kisqali was also significantly more effective at delaying disease progression versus a non-steroidal aromatase inhibitor or fulvestrant alone. Kisqali can cause lung problems or an abnormal heartbeat, which can lead to death. It can cause serious skin reactions, liver problems, and low white blood cell counts that may result in severe infections. Tell your doctor right away if you have new or worsening symptoms, including breathing problems, cough, chest pain, a change in your heartbeat, dizziness, yellowing of the skin or eyes, dark urine, tiredness, loss of appetite, abdomen pain, bleeding, bruising, fever, chills, or other symptoms of an infection, a severe or worsening rash, are or plan to become pregnant or breastfeeding. Avoid grapefruit during treatment. Kisqali is not approved for use with tamoxifen. It's our time to continue to shine because we are the thrivers. Ask your doctor about Kisqali, the only treatment in its class proven to help women live longer in 2 clinical trials.
Whether you're looking to connect with customers, find new ones, or sell more of your awesome stuff, Constant Contact has powerful email marketing tools and more to help you do more business online. Power on with Constant Contact. Try it free today.
Nature's Bounty unleashes something exciting. Say hello to a drug-free way to ease stress. Stress Comfort, a gummy supplement with lemon balm plus saffron to naturally boost your mood. Stress Comfort from Nature's Bounty.
If you elect me, your taxes are going to be raised, not cut.
What does that mean for you? Household incomes down $6,500 a year. Higher gas prices at the pump and utility bills at home.
And here's how it works. I'm going to raise taxes.
Small businesses pay more. 5 million jobs lost.
You're going to get a tax raise.
An economy in ruins. That's what Joe Biden's tax increase means for you.
I'm Donald J. Trump, and I approve this message.
Tonight at 5, the U.S. Supreme Court has ruled that Wisconsinites' ballots must be in by Election Day. What voting groups want you to know ahead of Election Day at 5.
Skies will be sunny tomorrow with high temperatures back to around 50 degrees. Thursday and Friday will be a little cooler, but it'll stay dry for a while. My forecast at 5.
And ahead at 6, why you should make a plan to return your absentee ballot in person or get it in the mail today. We'll have that story for you tonight on News 3 Now at 6.
Picture of over the UW-Madison campus on this Tuesday afternoon. Nice sunshine, a little chilly.
But warming up.
Yeah, not a bad week ahead. With just a week to go now until Election Day, most Americans overseas have already voted.
Nearly 3 million U.S. citizens living abroad are eligible to cast ballots. Poll watchers say they're already seeing signs of a massive turnout from U.S. citizens living overseas. Some Americans in London aren't taking any chances with the Postal Service, instead choosing to drive their ballots to a special mailbox at the U.S. Embassy.
This felt like a more secure way for me to make sure that my voice was heard.
Americans can even cast ballots when they're away from Earth. Most U.S. astronauts live in Houston, and Texas law allows them to vote from space using secure electronic ballots.
That's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool. Well, there have been reports of long voting lines across the country, so how are people passing the time?
Some are reading, some are catching up on television, and others are busting a move. CNN's Jeannie Most reports on the latest dance hotspot.
How do you kill time while waiting in the early voting line? Try the Mississippi Cha-Cha Slide. Gives a whole new meaning to the right and left when it comes to voting. Scenes like this from Philadelphia were inspired by Joy to the Polls, a sort of roving concert. Entertaining lines of voters.
We want to make it as fun as possible and just motivate people to stay in line. So he was just somebody who was waiting in line, and that video went viral.
I can't get over how long that guy's legs are, posted one admirer. Across the country in Portland, Oregon, a guy who calls himself Two Less Legs was also getting serenaded.
Yo, we got somebody here voting today for the first time.
Never have music and voting seemed in such harmony, from a marching band outside early voting in Brooklyn to an activist doing a little ballot ballet in New Jersey. To a nonprofit delivering free pizzas to lines of voters with a side helping of salsa, the organizer of Joy to the Polls made clear.
Even though we are bringing joy, I wish we didn't have to.
She wishes voters weren't forced to wait for hours. Joy to the Polls sent up a drone.
Good time. Come on. One time.
To capture the long lines and dancing voters instead of that kind of pole dancing.
Get your booty to the pole.
This type of pole dancing is G-rated. Woo! Jeannie Most, CNN, New York.
Way to pass the time.
Whatever it takes
to get you
to vote.
Go and vote. Still to come at 4, a new study shows the pandemic is taking a mental health toll on young people.
We'll tell you what signs could spell trouble in your child and what you can do to help them cope, plus what resources are available. That's when Live at 4 continues.
One of our favorite Portage families here at the Portage Furniture Store, the Ayers family that has grown a little bit since, yeah, he says high five. That's right. Since the last time we were here.
We sure have. It's Austin and I, proud third generation owners, and now we're working on our fourth generation. We've seen generations of customers come through, and I think we take a lot of joy in seeing, hey, my parents bought from your dad or bought from your uncles or bought from your grandpa, mm-hmm. and now Austin and I get to enjoy that ourselves.
How much fun is it on the days you come back into town and the three of you are together?
It's very special. Like I said, the longevity from my dad and uncle started in 1940 to now, very special.
We're very, very proud to showcase predominantly American-made brands and companies that we've worked with for a very long time. We have a number of great lines, including Serta Mattresses, Smith Brothers, Flexsteel, Lazy Boy, and England.
And not everyone has the Ayers last name, but everybody here, I know you guys consider family.
Yeah, we really have some wonderful people here, including, you know, two salespeople, Rosie and Punky, who have been here with us from the very beginning, and we're really thankful for them.
Yeah, they really make you guys, they're the ones who make you all look good.
Yeah,
they are.
No doubt.
And we need all the help we can get.
Yeah, well, he said it. What are some of the biggest things that set you guys apart?
The free delivery. Yeah.
They still got it. I was wondering.
We do.
Glad to hear it.
And on top of a first-class free delivery service, we're very proud of our huge selection of top-name brand furniture at guaranteed low prices.
Well, with the free delivery, we've got a lot of stops, but I'm glad you're helping me. From the Portage Furniture Store, I'm Emmy Fink, and you're buzzed into Madison. He's excited.
Joe Biden was raised with middle-class values.
Joe doesn't need to be the center of attention or see himself on TV. He has always focused on getting the job done. Joe led us out of the 2008 recession and increased health coverage for millions. As president, Joe will focus on getting us out of our crises. He'll listen to experts, work across the aisle, and put the American people first. FFPAC is responsible for the content of this ad.
Here's how my plan works. Anyone making less than $400,000 a year won't pay a penny more. I'm going to ask the very big corporations to pay their fair share. We're going to invest in creating millions of good-paying jobs. We're going to ease the burden of the major cost in your life, health care. We're going to protect Social Security, increase the benefits for millions of seniors. When I announced I was running, I said that's the reason to rebuild the backbone of this country. Hard-working folks in the middle class.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
Right now, we aren't seeing any major delays on the road. Always good news when I don't have accidents to report, but it is one of those evenings that you'll definitely want to have these sunglasses on when you're driving home, especially if you're driving west into the setting sun right now. Along the Beltline, all looks pretty smooth. Downtown Madison, a few slowdown spots, but overall, things moving along just fine again. Nothing that looks any different compared to this time any other day during the week. Janesville looks good in the interstate from Dane County through Rock County. We aren't seeing any delays right now for this chilly evening. 25 minutes to get from Janesville to the Beltline, 16 minutes to get from Sauk City to Middleton, and some prey to downtown. A quick 9-minute drive this evening. That's a quick look at traffic.
Thank you. Check out this massive real-life Pac-Man game board carved in an Illinois field. It was created using Caterpillar construction equipment near the company's Peoria headquarters. The 200-by-200-foot maze was built to celebrate the company's 95th anniversary, and it actually coincides with the 40th anniversary of the iconic game. Various Caterpillar machines and technology were used to create different textures to give the maze a 3D look. Banners were then added to finish the board, and then it was game time. Employees used remotes to control the company's equipment to go head-to-head, and all the gargantuan gaming goodness was shared on social media.
What a great idea. I don't know if you can hear Dana clapping. That's her hometown, Peoria, Illinois.
Hey.
Check that out.
That's super cool. My mom loves Pac-Man. We might have to make this happen, guys.
All right.
That is really cool.
Well, a recent report from the CDC shows the rates of anxiety and depression among adolescents has tripled since the pandemic began.
That is alarming, but there are ways we can help our children and each other as we enter the colder months. Earlier today, we talked with the medical director of Unity Point Health Meritor's Child and Adolescent Psychiatry Hospital, Dr. Katie Schmidt.
So what trends are we seeing in kids struggling right now?
In the hospital, we're seeing a definite trend involving social isolation. You know, these kids now for months have been unable to participate in pro-social activities. They're not going to school with their friends. They're not doing the things they enjoy, like sports or music or engaging in things that bring them self-esteem. So I would say isolation is just wearing down so many kids. And I think the other thing is that we don't know when it's going to end. So it's not like the kids can mentally set an end date and say, okay, I got to go till, you know, January or February. It's this uncertainty. And I think that breeds a lot of hopelessness and anxiety and just uncertainty about, you know, when things are going to go back to normal for them.
Kids are struggling and parents are struggling. What are some of the things that parents should be paying attention to and watching for at home with their kids that could be signs of trouble?
That's a great question. And I think there are a lot of different things that parents should be on the lookout for. Some of them involve like symptoms. So maybe noticing that their kids are experiencing lower energy. They're just not wanting to engage in some of the things that they used to find really pleasurable or enjoyable, but also function. So a lot of kids they're just not logging into school. They feel overwhelmed. So they're just closing their laptop, right? They're disconnecting. So I would say more of like an impairment in keeping up with schoolwork, keeping up with just sleep. Sleep structure has been impacted so severely because there's just not that structure and routine. So kids are going to bed much later. They're waking up later. So everything's just being shifted. So I would look for some of those symptoms, but also some of their kids' ability to function.
What can parents do to help in that area?
I think trying to provide some of that. So I really encourage families, put a structure in place. A lot of parents aren't at home anymore. They're going to work, so the kids are at home alone when they're doing their education. So try to put a structure in place. This is when you're going to do school, take a break for movement, take a break for lunch. And I think helping kids then stick to a sleep schedule, take care of their bodies, you know, whether that's eating healthy, being active, just that structure and routine and spending time together. I think that's really important moving forward, especially in the winter months.
We're very lucky to have the Child and Adolescent Psychiatry Hospital in our community. It's a resource there when families need help. What other resources are available for people who really need some support right now?
Yeah, and that's also such a great thing to bring up, Susan, because a lot of the resources in the community are overwhelmed. A lot of the kids trying to establish care now are doing it virtually, and it's hard to connect to people that way. Also, a lot of those in-home family services, they're on pause or they're trying to do it virtually, which is also a challenge, but still so important to reach out. I would definitely start with your primary care provider. If parents are concerned about their kids, reaching out to them for therapy referrals or just checking in with the kids to make sure they're doing okay. You can also access your insurance company to see which therapist they may recommend. Also reaching out to schools. So they still have support staff, guidance counselors. So reaching out to them, not only for the social support and emotional support, but for academic support as well.
And we don't know what the long-range effect of all this is going to be down the road.
Mm-hmm. We don't. And right, it's the crisis within the crisis. We're hearing so many of those things where COVID is causing these changes, but there's so many downstream effects that we're going to be supporting our kids and adults through for a long time.
Help is out there, and it's
that's good to know.
And seek it.
Yeah.
Katie, thanks for being with us today.
Keep up the great work, Katie. Thanks so much for your time.
Stay well.
Take care, you guys.
Help is on the way.
Yeah, it's a remarkable, remarkable service that we have. Mm. We're lucky to have it here in Madison.
We'll have a final check of your forecast coming up.
Ready to roll playback?
Do you have dry, cracked hands from constant washing, cold weather, and hard work? Try O'Keefe's Working Hands. It's America's number one selling hand cream for guaranteed relief for extremely dry, cracked hands. Also available in O'Keefe's Lip Repair. Guaranteed relief for extremely dry, cracked lips.
If I have the honor of being president, I promise you I will lead. My plan lowers healthcare costs, gets us to universal coverage quickly when Americans desperately need it. By making it less expensive for Americans to choose plans with lower deductibles and out-of-pocket expenses. By lowering prescription drug prices. By ending the practice of so-called surprise billings. When I'm president, I will take care of your healthcare coverage and your family the same way I would my own.
I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message. I started this campaign saying we're in the battle for the soul of the nation. I believe that even more deeply today. Who we are, what we stand for, and maybe most importantly, who we are going to be. It's all at stake. Character is on the ballot. The character of the country. And this is our opportunity to leave the dark, angry politics of the past 4 years behind us. To choose hope over fear. Unity over division. Science over fiction. I believe it's time to unite the country. To come together as a nation. But I can't do it without you. So I'm asking for your vote. We need to remember, this is the United States of America. And there's never been anything we've been unable to do when we've done it together. I'm Joe Biden, and I approve this message.
This election season, politicians are targeting Wisconsin, making promises and claims to capture your vote. But you deserve the truth. Only Reality Check gives you the tools you need to make informed choices. I'm News 3 Now political reporter Amy Reed. I'm breaking down political ads, explaining whose money is behind them and separating truth from misinformation. Get the facts with Reality Check, only on News 3 Now.
Folks, Wednesday morning, we're taking a closer look at the growing gaps in communication when it comes to the political divide in Wisconsin.
And with less than a week until the election, we'll tell you how organizers are working to get more people of color out to the polls.
We'll see you Wednesday morning on News 3 Now.
Is it real or is it misinformation?
People have a hard time telling the difference.
An expert tracks one false election post that spread like wildfire.
How did a Wisconsin voter feel about being tricked?
News 3 Now investigates Wednesday at 10.
Here's a live.
live look at downtown right now. We've said already, plenty of sunshine today. It really is just a nice fall day. Overall, not too windy and not too cold, just a little chilly. We did hit 40 degrees. That was a nice break over the last 3 days with the clouds and the cooler weather. 40 thanks to that southwest breeze, about 9 miles per hour. Dew points are in the teens, so it's very dry, and it's going to stay dry. Those temperatures, about 43 in Janesville, 37 towards Camp Douglas, a bit warmer than where we were at this time yesterday, and warmer than where we started the day. Thankfully, we don't have to look at these overnight lows again for quite some time, as a little warming trend will carry us towards Halloween.
That's good news. All right, Dana, thank you. Tomorrow on Live at 4, Lisa Briggs from the Bruce Company is here taking your plant and garden questions.
And Marquette Law School poll director Charles Franklin will be here with the latest polling numbers in Wisconsin before Election Day. That's coming up tomorrow on Live at 4.